This series has been planned for 4 to 5 episodes, but I guess it's my fault for saying. But if you have wishes or ideas, besides the here listed points, which will be done in the upcoming episodes, let me know in the comments or join my Discord. I'm definitely planning on doing some updates based on your wishes. So here we are, to the second additional episode of Force Valerie to do more Tilemap building tutorial things. But to be fair, I instantly love the idea of today's topic. We are going to create cute little undo and redo buttons for undoing and redoing user interaction. The whole build history will be kept in memory and is available during the full game session. Well, at least as long as you don't destroy the according manager. So, let's start. I already created two buttons, matching my beautiful UI style. Currently, they do nothing. Just shimmer a little bit red on hover. Both buttons are located in an empty game object for some structure. Like a default Unity button, it contains a button and an image component. But I removed the text child. The image is a simple arrow image I created. And the redo button is the same but mirrored with a -1 as X scale. There are no click interactions. We will code them now. Let's create a script which will handle the direct input from the buttons. I call it BuildingHistory Handler. Import the UnityEngine.ui package and add a serialized field for both buttons with the type button. Now we create two private methods for our buttons. For now, they won't do anything. In the awake method, we can now assign an onClickListener to both buttons to the according method. For now, this is everything in this method. We will add more later. Back in Unity, add the script to your manager object and assign the button value. So let's create a second script I call just building history. At first, let's define what we want to save. For this, I create a new class right below this one. It will be a plain C# class and is called building history item. In our case, we have 4 relevant entries we need to know in order to undo or redo a specific step. This is the tile map, the position on this map, the tile base which was previously there, and the one which is now there. Also add a constructor, which will take all 4 values. Now it's time for some magic. I add an undo and redo method. All we do is set either the previous or the new tile at the position for the tile map. Yes, it can be that easy. But let's keep on. Make sure your methods are public. Our building history class can now save all the items we create when drawing onto the tile map in a list of building history items. To know where we currently are in this list, we also add an integer for the index. Make sure the start value is -1, so that when we add the first item to this list, we can count it up to 0, which matches the index of the list. Let's create some public methods, which will handle the interaction with the list. The first one is, of course, an add method. It will take a building history item as parameter. We add the item to the list and count up our index. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind is that we might already be somewhere back in the history, and adding an item would not add it right now, where the index is, but rather at the end. For this problem, we use the most common approach. Adding something will delete the history for redo steps. With remove range, we delete everything in our list, starting from the current index +1. The second parameter is the amount of entries we want to remove. This is the difference between the list length and the current index +1. This will also work if the index is already at the end of the list and will just not remove anything. The second method is an option for undoing a step. This is what gets called when clicking the button. We will check if the current index is greater -1 to make sure there is something we can undo. Now we can call the undo method we defined in the building history item, right there. This will then change the tiles on the map according to its variables. Since this entry is now undone, we will decrement the index to the entry before. The third method is the redo method and behaves like the undo method. But we will check if the current index is less than the overall length of the list, minus 1. So if the current entry is not the last entry, then we increment the index to the previously undone element and call its method for redoing. For easy references, let's make the building history a singleton. We discussed this topic first in episode 1 of this series. So if this does not work for you, check the link in the description. It includes a timestamp to the relevant part. Switch back to the building history handler. Now we will add a reference to the building history. Thanks to the singleton, we can now easily grab the instance in the awake method. In our empty methods, we can now call the according methods of building history. But for now, our list is still empty. For this, switch to your building creator script. Like in the history handler, we need to add a reference to the building history script first. At the bottom of the script is the only point where we write to the tilemaps. For now, we ignore the tool part. At first, let's make sure we are not drawing to the preview map. Then we can just call the buildingHistoryAdd method. In the parameter, create a new buildingHistory item and assign the parameters. To get the previous tile, which is now still the current tile, use the getTile method on the tilemap. Do this before you actually change the tile on the map. So you can finally test your script now. Let's draw some things and whoa, we can remove them and then add them back to the map. But yeah, okay, the rectangle, which was only one step when drawing, consists of all the single tiles now. That's the difference between working and actually being good. But don't worry, we will upgrade our code and also include a functionality to get it to work with the tools system. And we are going to do this in the next episode, so that the series looks like it has more content than it actually has. Or something like this. I'm just not in the mood to edit such a long video again, but I'm sure you can live with this. I mean, just look at the result of the next episode. So stay tuned. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick and Naxwomo. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoy the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.